Hi, I'm Runzhi Zeng, and I will briefly introduce our new paper, Compact and Tightly Selective-Opening Secure Public Key Encryption Schemes. This is joint work with Jiaxin Pine. And in the PKE setting, we have a receiver, and the receiver have a public key and secret key. We have a lot of senders, and they can use the public key to encrypt some message with some randomness, and then send the ciphertext to the receiver. We consider a setting that now the sender's randomness and message will be revealed to some adversary. And because the adversary gets the message and randomness, it can completely break the security of the ciphertext. We say a ciphertext is open if its randomness and message are both revealed. So now some ciphertexts are open, and we will ask, how about the unopened ciphertext? Do the unopened ciphertext remain secure? And the sender selected opening security considers such setting, or shortly, SO security. In the SO security, the adversary gets a bunch of challenge ciphertexts, and it can also open some of the challenge ciphertexts. The SO security requires that the unopened challenge ciphertexts remain secure. SO security is a very practical notion. For example, sometimes the sender's computer may be corrupted by some hacker, and the hacker can get all the information about the sender, including messages and the randomness. Or the sender can maybe use some insecure randomness generator, and the adversary can recover the such insecure randomness. The selective opening security has been studied for a long time, and it can date back to the 1999. There are two flavors of SO security notion: indistinguished ability-based SO security and a simulation-based SO security, or shortly SIM SO security. In this work, we just focus on the SIM SO security. And it turns out that the SIM SO security is strictly stronger than the standard PKE security notion, like the INDCCA. And it's highly non-trivial to achieve SIM SO security because there's a dilemma. If we want to prove security, we should embed some problem instance into the ciphertext. But if we embed the instance to the ciphertext, then we cannot open the ciphertext because we do not have the randomness. And for example, one may wonder if we can use the hybrid argument plus an INDCCA secure PKE to achieve the same SO security. This such hybrid argument doesn't work because if we want to use the hybrid argument to switch the challenge ciphertext to random, then we can open the ciphertext. And of course, there's a trivial solution to deal with such problem. We just guess which ciphertext will not be opened by the adversary, but this solution is not very good because there's some failure probability. Since the reduction may guess wrong and it leads to some non-tight security. So let me ask, can we have SIM SOCCA scheme with tight security? The answer is yes, but it's not very satisfactory. Some group-based SIM SOCPKEs with tight security, they have a long ciphertext or long public key. Long public key means that the number of group elements in the public key is not a constant. It depends on the length of the message. And long ciphertext similarly. The drawback is that the non-compact PKE, they have a very high communication overhead. So in this one, we want to solve this problem. Can we have a SIM SOCCA scheme such that it achieves the tight security, compact public key, and compact ciphertext at the same time? And we find this problem is very hard, and we want to relax some requirements. How about in the random oracle model? Can we have such a scheme in the random oracle model? Our paper gives a positive answer to this question. We propose three direct constructions and a generic construction. They are all compact and tightly same SOCCA skill in the random oracle model. There are some techniques used in our paper, but I'm not going to introduce them there. And our full talk will be given in the Thursday morning. And thank you for your attention. We also thank Benedict Wagner for his helpful comments.